How you doing, YouTubers? Appreciate you tuning in. I'm Jimmy. We're making it work. Project truck's going to get a new fan and a new air cleaner because that air cleaner on there right now, I don't really like it. The K&N filter I bought doesn't sit in that housing not correctly. It's not made for it. We got a better one. Well, at least one that'll fit well and seal the air filter up. We got a stronger fan for the radiator. Let's get to it. Stay tuned. Well, that's the fan I took out of there. You can see how lightweight it is and how small the motor is. I'm guessing it was probably like a 900 CFM fan. I'm not really sure. So I'll show you the spall fan. I've already mounted it up. It was quick and easy. I had to drill four holes and bolted it right up. And look at that motor compared to this one. Put them both in the same shot. See that motor compared to that one. So this fan ought to be able to keep the temperature a little lower. So we'll see. I'm gonna run it now, try to make sure it warms up good. The fan should cycle on, and then after a couple of minutes, pull the temperature down enough that it shuts back off. This one never would. With the shroud, it stopped it from overheating, but it never brought it down low enough to shut itself off. So we'll see how the new fan does. All right, let's fire this thing up. Let it warm up a little bit. See how that fan does. Make sure it's in neutral. It's always good. Got my choke a little better now too. I'm gonna let it warm up. We'll come back when the fan turns on. All right, my fan turned on, so now we're gonna wait and see. Hopefully the fan will turn off.
It's like a jetty.
Way more air than the other fan. Still not pulling the temperature down enough to turn the fan off. But there's a lot of warm air coming off of there. Well, we tried. I'm gonna have to drive it, make sure it doesn't get hotter, and see what happens with the temperature that way. Cut a piece of threaded rod to length. Got my air filter. Check it out. And I got a red anodized nut, just a quarter 20 threaded rod, quarter 20 nut. Two of these for $5 on Amazon. So the coup d'etat, or a finishing touch, flowing air filter top and side. I watched a bunch of dyno videos where this filter top, actually they taped this off and gained 3 horsepower. So, of course, the best performing filter they had in the dyno test was a salad bowl with the bottom cut open a 5 1/4 inch hole. So, we're making progress. Make sure this thing is tuned up nice and the choke works good. And try to make sure our fan is gonna do its job on a road test. That's gonna be next. Well, since it's slow in the shop and there's no work for me, everyone's busy. Vacation guy doesn't get any work. Might as well go up and put some super unleaded. This thing's supposed to have 91 octane. And I believe there's 87 in it now. So I'm gonna go to the gas station, put some gas in it.
Short people, right? They go on certain rides and
front rear tire doesn't stand a chance. This thing breaks that right rear tire loose with no effort. Now it's getting posies and all kinds of stuff. Oh, I guess it'll protect my little S10 transmission because it just spins the tire instead of blowing it up so far. This motor is ridiculously strong. Second most powerful engine I've ever had. Detonation, man. But I'm still gonna put in what it's supposed to have.
What are the odds that'll give me a receipt? Oh, none. The odds are zero. Next round of upgrades. Let's go in and see if there's some work to do.